to rock a throwback, ballin' on a corner. Now I rock a telesuit, looking like a owner. No, I'm not a Jonas, brother, I'm a groaner. No, I'm not, I use my
All right, what's going on, y'all? It's your boy Rock. You see what it is, man. Got my late show popping. And I figure I'll come up on here and give y'all a nice little 2K13, nice little presentation. You know what I'm saying? Nice little commentary. I know it's been a minute, but, you know, I actually got a lot to talk about as far as, you know, my Lakers, what I think they're going to do this season. And, of course, talk a little bit about 2K13, what I think about it. But let me get started with my Lakers, man. I might as well, because I'm feeling a real championship-like. As you see, my boy Cole get the nice little steal, and you know, he don't get nothing going, so you know, we pass it to Nash, and Nash make sure he gets it going. Nash, you know, one thing I noticed about having Steve Nash on the team, you know, without having to see him play, is that he's gonna command a lot of double teams, because you know, Nash, he's a problem on the court, straight up and down. You know what I'm saying? That's what I noticed on this game too. Like, he's like one of the most efficient offensive players on our team. You know what I'm saying? He can hit pretty much any shot. He's good on the outside. He's good on the inside. And, of course, he got that three ball. And then, of course, you see the big fella down there, Dwight. You know, I noticed, like, with him, it seemed like, you know, and all this I'm kind of getting from 2K13 because, you know, we haven't seen him play. But it seemed like Dwight is pretty much going to be the anchor of the team. You know what I'm saying? He's that guy that's pretty much going to be running on the fast breaks, you know what I'm saying? Y'all saw Pippen hit that little clutch time shot. But, you know, I think he's going to be that guy. Basically, you know, the defensive stopper on the team. Because, you know, I mean, Bynum last year, he did that a lot for us. But he wasn't consistent, you know what I'm saying? That was my issue, really, with Bynum. Was that he didn't want to do it every game, you know what I'm saying? It was like that series in the playoffs against the Nuggets, you know what I'm saying? He had 10 blocks one game. But then the rest of the series, you didn't hear shit from him. And I was like, okay, I didn't really like that. You know what I'm saying? And that's one thing you can't take from Dwight Howard, man. Everybody knows that Dwight Howard, he makes sure he comes and he plays every night. And the thing about last year was that he averaged like 20 and 14 on a bad back. Like, all last year, his back was bad. So, you know, I think this year, man, it's looking real good for Lakers. And then, if y'all got 2K13, and if you don't know, on 2K, they rated number one. You know what I'm saying? Number one overall. So, and really, I just think it's because of the height. And I notice it. Like, when I bring in, like, Antoine Jameson, I don't really see too many teams has got as much height as the Lakers do. That's one thing about the Lakers it's always been. We always had, you know, big fellas on the squad. You see Dwight Howard. Jordan tried to throw that little weak shit up. You know, you have to get that shit taken care of. Look at Powell. I've never seen Powell Gasol do a Euro step, so... You know, it's a couple little things in this game that's kind of fucked up. But for the most part, I think this game is pretty solid. You know, it kind of threw me off with the shot stick. You know, they changed the shot stick to, like, the dribbling. You know, kind of like old school live. But, you know, the dribbling, like, right there fucked me up. I tried to use the shot stick, but it's all good because Dwight Howard come with the cleanup. But still, it's like, man, you know, it kind of messed me up. I'm still adjusting my game to it. So just like I was telling my homies, like I feel like I gotta kind of relearn the controls again, which is not a bad thing. You know what I'm saying? It's always good. I think that's a good thing because, you know, me, myself, I personally abuse the shot stick. You know, a lot of people didn't know that the shot stick actually made you shoot a lot better, especially, you know, on a superstar like Kevin Durant, Kobe, you know, Carmelo. They made all their mid-range shots pretty much go in. You have to play serious defense to stop that mid-range shot if you use the shot stick correctly. But now, you know, it kind of, I don't know, holding that button, it kind of fucks me up. You see right there, I couldn't believe that. Dwight Howard got his shit beat to death by Luke Longley. Stop it. So, you know, I'm about to try and get some revenge. And Big Pal going to set himself up. I think we're going to see a lot of that right there next year. I see a lot of that, you know. It's a lot of interior passing going on, and then, you know, I've been sitting back looking and playing this game, and I've noticed that basically, you know, even from when I was just playing this game last year to this year, because last year I was playing games, I did the whole trade, put Dwight Howard on the team, and I was still going off with Kobe then, but I kind of noticed more now that I really use the squad. I really think Kobe, man, I think his points gonna go down. Either his points gonna go down or his shot attempts are just gonna go down. You know what I'm saying? Because I think he's gonna get better looks. You know, well, having Nash on the team is just, I don't know. It's hard not to do good. You know what I'm saying? So it's definitely a good thing. But the 2K13, man. You know, you see right there. Ooh, that's how Pippen feel. Pippen was a juggernaut of defense, man. Straight up. But yeah, man, I've been having a lot of fun with this. So I'm still trying to think what I want to do. I haven't made my mind player yet. And my mind player gonna come soon. You know, I'm real busy with my work and all that bullshit. But you know, I think I'm about to actually start up a season, and I'm gonna put myself on the Lakers. You know, myself. And when I mean myself, I really mean this time I'm gonna put myself. You know, I'm 5'11", about 230. You know what I'm saying? Except, of course, I'm cheating. I'm gonna be able to dunk and all that bullshit. You know, 360 through the legs dunks. But I think I'm gonna do a little quick season, and I'm gonna see how far we go. I'm gonna even come off the bench, and even though I come off the bench, I'm gonna be better than Steve Nash. So I'm gonna be the point guard. I'm gonna be a 5'11 point guard, handles. You know, I just can't wait. I'm gonna see what I could do with him. But look at Nash. This is what he's gonna bring. That 3-point shot is just gonna make us deadly. You know what I'm saying? I'm over here. I just can't wait, man, because that's something that my Lakers been missing. I never, you know, that's my squad. So I'm always that guy that got to use the Lakers when my homeboys come over, because they, you know, they either use somebody else or they just want to call my Lakers out. A lot of people not doing a lot of calling out this year, my Lakers, but it's all gravy, man. But, you know, we're going to see what to do. Even look at Kobe. Kobe said he had to get him some. I mean, it's just going nasty with 3-point shots. So, you know, I can't wait, man. It's, I don't know. I think everybody's percentage is going to go up. And then I ain't even got to that big fella pal. I think he's gonna flourish this year. You know, with having Dwight Howard down there is gonna take a lot of load off of him, because the thing about Powell, what people didn't really mention, look at Kobe breaking. Yeah, you know, you got to break Jordan off a little bit. That's the thing, Kobe gonna get his. But yeah, man, that's like I was saying, man. It's gonna take a lot of load off Pau Gasol, man, because you know, with last year having Big Bynum, you know, like I said before, he used to take nights off. And the thing about Dwight Howard, he's not going to take a night off. So the times he was taking nights off, it basically made Pau Gasol have to pick up his pieces. And Pau Gasol can't do that every night. He doesn't have the mental strength enough to do it. Everybody know Pau is soft, but he does have a good skill set. That's what you can't take from him. He is a good player at the end of the day, but he's still soft. You know what I'm saying? That's just like Chris Bosh. I think Chris Bosh is the softest in the world, but he got a good skill set. You know what I'm saying? So look at Cole. He just, you know, we had to just pour it on him at the end, man. But yeah, man, this commentary coming to an end, man. Let me know what y'all want to see. I actually got another 2K13 video I'm put up next. It's the Dream Team versus, you know, the Jordan Dream Team versus the Kobe Dream Team. And we're going to see how it go, man. I went bananas with Jordan on there. You know, I have to go old school. You know, I like the old fellas. Went off with Bird from the three. You see what it is, man. We handed it to the Bulls. I just did this to see whose team was better. And, of course, we had a better team than Jordan did. So, that's why I think I'm going to win the championship. But, yes, be your boy, Rock. Go ahead, rate, comment, subscribe. Tap the thumbs up.